Thank you, Billy. I really like that line about being the most important person at USC. I suspect that some of my faculty colleagues would say that a university president is like the man who mows the grass in a large cemetery. He has a lot of people under him, but they don't pay much attention to what he has to say. In any event, it's a privilege for me to be here on this very special evening. It's a great honor for me to pay tribute to the legendary Kirk Douglas, a man whose immense talents are matched only by his social conscience. I should like to thank everyone here tonight for recognizing Dr. Douglas and for your loyal support of the USC Shoah Foundation Institute for Visual History and Education. I should also like to thank two great friends of USC who have made this evening possible, Dr. Steven Spielberg and Dr. Wallace Annenberg. First, Dr. Spielberg. Now, I call him Doctor because in 1994, USC awarded him an honorary doctorate. He's been an important member of our Board of Trustees since 1996. As a filmmaker, Steven Spielberg is a man of great creativity and imagination. As the founding chairman of the Shoah Foundation, it's clear that he is also a man of great foresight and compassion. I should also like to thank last year's recipient of the Ambassadors for Humanity Award, Dr. Wallace Annenberg. Wallace is the longest-serving voting member of the USC Board of Trustees, and she also received an honorary doctorate from USC in 2003, and she is very passionate about public service. She's a champion of many important causes, such as the arts, medicine, and education, and her efforts are truly enhancing the lives of countless people from coast to coast and around the world. Thanks to people such as Wallace Annenberg and Steven Spielberg, the Shoah Foundation Institute found a home at USC. It's not easy to establish an institute at USC. We're very selective. We want programs that reflect our values. We want curricula that advance our educational goals. And we want institutes that can truly make a difference. From the very beginning, the Shoah Foundation Institute and USC were a perfect match. USC's role and mission statement says that we help our students acquire moral discernment and respect and appreciation for others. Our code of ethics states that we nurture an environment of mutual respect and tolerance, and that we speak out against hatred and bigotry whenever and wherever we find them. At the heart of education is a spirit of inquiry, a questioning attitude. Tonight, I should like to share a few questions with you. Do you believe that society can learn from the past? If we don't continue to preserve the Institute's more than 52,000 testimonies, will they then be forgotten? If we don't share these histories with students, scholars, and researchers, both at USC and around the world, then who will? And if we don't teach children around the globe the facts about the Holocaust and Rwanda and Darfur, then who will? Now, I'm an eternal optimist. I believe we can and must learn from the past. I believe that a change of heart begins with a change of mind. And I believe the best cure for ignorance is education. We can no longer tolerate intolerance. We cannot condone bigotry. We cannot permit prejudice to exist unremarked, and I strongly believe that the USC Shoah Foundation Institute for Visual History and Education is one of the very best ways to help us eliminate prejudice, intolerance, and bigotry forever. Thank you.